Today we're at the Eaton Experience Center in Warrendale, Pennsylvania, and we want to talk about the new Form 7 recloser control that we have just installed. And that Form 7 is connected to the new NXT recloser, which we've got up at the top of the pole. Talk about a few of the features of the NXT recloser. First thing we want to talk about is, what is an NXT recloser? It is a triple single design. So it is three independent operating mechanisms electrically ganged off of the Form 7 control. So on the recloser itself, we have three yellow manual lockout handles on the mechanism. And by their name, they will manually lock out the recloser even if there is no power to the device. So we're going to show the operation of the yellow manual lockout handle. So if we pull those yellow handles down, go up with our hot stick. There we go. If we pull the yellow handle down, even though we pulled down one yellow handle, all three phases locked out. And that is because the recloser right now is set up for a three-phase ganged lockout operation. So when you're in three-phase lockout mode, pulling down one yellow handle will trip and lock out the other two phases. When the yellow handle is down, it blocks any closing. On the NXT recloser, it's both electrically interlocked and mechanically interlocked to prevent closing. So for example, we've still got the yellow handle down up there, and we're showing that we're tripped and locked out on all three phases. If I come in and push the close button, nothing happens. Recloser will not close while we've got that yellow handle in the down position. If we want to be able to close the recloser, we first have to push the yellow handle back up. That re-engages it for closing, and now we need to be able to have a functional control to be able to close it. So I can push the close button, send a SCADA command, whatever, and be able to close the recloser in. With the NXT recloser, the position indicator, the mechanical position indicator, is located on the underside of the tanks. That makes it easy for crews to be able to quickly and easily be able to tell the status of the recloser contacts. The contact position indicator is made out of a reflective material so that at night it's easily viewable. Just shine your truck light up on the indicator, and you've got the very easy indication of status. The indicator is a 360 view, so you can see that from any direction from the bottom of the recloser. So we want to talk about some other parts of the or features of the NXT recloser. So what we have here is a single pole of an NXT recloser, a demo, and we can show some of the features of the NXT on this demo. So the material is a solid epoxy, a cycloaliphatic epoxy. It's vacuum interruption. Vacuum bottle actually resides right in here and is encapsulated in the cycloaliphatic epoxy. You have the load side bushing and the source side bushing right here. The cycloaliphatic epoxy is a very durable, very good at withstanding polluted salt spray type of environments. Very excellent material for use in outdoor reclosers. Reclosers themselves historically were overcurrent protection devices, but in today's day of distributed generation and changes to the distribution system, it's a lot of times not enough to have just current sensing. The NXT is designed to implement into more complex distribution systems. From that standpoint, the NXT is got voltage capability. This example here, we have six voltage sensors on a three-phase design. So the source side voltage sensor is actually embedded in the epoxy here. And the load side sensor is an integrated sensor. On this side, it connects to the load side bushing. So on a three-phase recloser, you would have six potential sensors here. The sensors that Eaton uses are a resistive divider type of sensor. Resistive divider is a very good voltage sensor in that it accuracy is constant throughout the whole temperature range of the recloser. Another feature of the NXT is the cable connection. Historically on reclosers, the cable connection was a screw-on connector that you know would take 10 to 15 turns possibly to fully seat the cable. With the NXT, the cable connection is a quarter turn quick lock style of connector. So there's no more guessing, do I have the cable tight or things along those lines. So the NXT cable connector gives you visual indication of whether the cable is in the right position and is firmly in place. So what I have here is two examples of the cable connectors to show this. So on the receptacle that would be, for example, in the bottom of the control cabinet, there is a blue tick mark on the receptacle that's mounted in the cabinet. On the cable itself, there's going to be a blue tick mark on the cable connector. So you match up the two blue tick marks, okay, push it in, you'll hear it the click. I'll draw your attention to the collar here. Just beyond the collar, there's a red surface. So if you see red, that indicates that I have not locked the cable in place. So I've got the two blue pushed together, okay? Now it's ready for the next step where I actually do the quarter turn and lock the cable. So I'd grab the collar, turn it, you'll hear a click, and the cable is firmly seated, can't pull it apart, and you no longer see the red on the collar. So I mentioned quarter turn positive lock cable system. Now I want to talk about how does that cable connect on the other end up at the recloser. Talked about the cable connecting at the bottom of the Form 7. Up at the recloser, there is a junction box mounted as part of the pole mounting frame. So if we go ahead and take a look at that junction box is located right back towards the pole, and there'll be the main control cable, and then you have the three individual cables that run to each of the reclosers. Up under the junction box, there is also three smaller control cables. Those are the control cables that run to each individual recloser tank. You'll notice that they are marked A, B, and C, so that if you want to make your phasing match your line maps, you can move those cables to line up to indicate which phase is the utility's phase A, phase B, or phase C. You can also do the phasing in the software programming if you so desire. So here we're in front of the new Form 7 recloser control. We talked about the NXT that it's connected to. So the Form 7 recloser control is powered from AC, so it brings in 120 volt AC from installed transformer or a customer service drop, and it's got a built-in battery backup. So the battery down here is a 24 volt lead acid 13 amp hour battery. The control runs off the AC. If AC is lost, it flips over and runs off the battery to power it up and to be able to operate, trip and close the recloser. If we open up the swing panel here and start looking at the design of the Form 7, we see it's a modular design, okay? And it's done that way to make it future-proof, if you will. Okay? We got expansion cards or boards capability out here. So in the future, adding additional COM cards or other features as developed or customer requests, we can slide in cards, slide out cards, so you don't have to dive into a lot of work to add features to the control. From a communication standpoint, as standard, the control comes with RS-232, also comes with a RJ45 Ethernet port. And for local connection, connecting up with the laptop, we have a USB connection down here for using the software for programming, using a memory stick to get the saving data out of the device, and so on. Memory is greatly enhanced. For example, the control can record over 1,500 different events, has oscillography and data gathering capability like that. So if we look at some of the other features that the Form 7 has, on the front panel, we have the 15 push buttons and numerous LED indication out here. In the software, there is a custom logic, which we call the workbench, where you can change, adapt, reprogram buttons and LEDs here on the front panel. Some of the other features with the Form 7 that are available, for example, you know, we have the classic fault protection that we've always had using the Kyle, Cooper, Eaton time current curves. Plus, we also allow use of, for example, the 50-51 elements, very inverse, extremely inverse, things like that. Has directionality protection. There's 8 protection profiles available in the control. Mentioned earlier with the NXT and the need in today's smart grid distributed generation, where it's more than just current, you need voltage. So in the NXT, we have 4 levels of under voltage protection levels. You can choose different pickups and times. 3 levels of over voltage, 6 levels of over frequency style protection. Another feature of the Form 7 recloser control is in the area of cybersecurity. The Form 7 is designed to have cybersecurity capability. So some of the features of the Form 7 is the door padlockable, and there's also an optional door switch that is available. From the communication side of the cybersecurity, some of the features of the Form 7 is that the control does role-based access control. So you can set up multiple users and give them certain access to the control. There's also audit trail included. So you can have a log of who has access to the control. The firmware is digitally signed to prevent rogue firmware from being introduced into the control. From a remote communications standpoint, supports TLS security, DMP secure authentication. We've got the radius server. So the Form 7 does support a radius server for providing additional protection. So thank you for watching the video today about the Nova NXT recloser and the Form 7 recloser control. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out and contact Eaton.